All right, before you start the mission, go to your start menu, and in the start menu, type in Device Manager. Probably just be able to just type device, and it'll come up on your listing. So click your Device Manager and go through each one of these individual things and find the driver for these things on the internet and save them to disk. The type of disk drive you have. The main one that's very important is your network adapter. Sorry about the shakiness, guys. So click on your network adapter and make sure you get that one. Of all of the drivers here, this one is going to be your main one you'll need. It's how your computer connects to the internet. So find that driver at least out of all of them and save it to disk. Your mouse driver might or could be handy as well. If it's just HID compliant mouse, that means it's just a basic mouse, and there's a 90% chance that it's going to be on the Windows 7 disk. And what type of keyboard? You'll need that too. See, it's another HID keyboard device, so just basic. So get all the drivers you can. Write out these things exactly as they're written. Make sure you go to the actual s website, so the AMD website or the Intel website or anything that's ATA. Just go through them all, write them down exactly how they're written out there, and collect as many of the drivers as you can find. You will probably be able to find additional drivers on the Windows update. So search those out before you start your format process. All right, and make sure you have yourself all your important CDs. If you have a CD for your motherboard, it's really handy. So have your Windows disk, video card disk. And this is a Windows XP disk that I copied. I broke the original. Stupid speaker fell off the computer and busted it. But this is an XP disk. I really like one of their options they have. You're not installing the XP, but it will have a option. I'll show you that later, how it comes in handy. Of course, I got a gigabyte disk. It'll have a lot of drivers that are handy. Now yours might have come with it, but with Windows 7, it's got quite or most drivers. I would recommend you have yourself plugged in just your basic mouse, like no bells and whistles mouse, just plain two buttons. There's a better chance that your Windows 7 will have the right driver for it. And same thing for a keyboard, just a basic keyboard, no volume controls on it, nothing like that. It's not necessary, but if you got a brand new video card or video card, brand new keyboard, there's a good chance you might not have the right driver in the Windows 7 program operating system. So gather up all that stuff. If you don't have the Windows 7 or the Windows XP disk, they're really cheap nowadays to pick them up. But you can do this without doing one step that I would recommend. All right, getting started. Now, if you have your keyboard and your mouse plugged into your computer, you probably should make sure that it's not plugged into the front here. These will be extra USB connections. It's better that you connect it to the top at the back. You'll see the mouse and keyboard connection up there. That will be your best bet. What else to say? Well, that's about it. All right, let's see. I'm trying to think if I'm missing anything. No, that should be it. Okay. First thing you want to do is shut down your computer. See, mine has started acting a little bit silly. I can tell when things are acting a little slow, and it's so. But anyhow, when you start your computer, you want to be ready to hit delete as soon as you see your splash screen. Mine will probably show up here first. So you can just rap on delete. And that'll bring up your BIOS page. And like I was saying, if you've forgotten your password, just start up your computer without that battery on your motherboard, and this won't show up. You'll just get this page. But using your arrow keys on your keyboard, then once, just navigate, just push over, and you'll see something that says load fails defaults. Hit that, you get this screen, say yeah, and then after I do that, I click on load optimized defaults, so that it doesn't glitch anything up. And hit enter, say yes. And then hit F10. It'll say save to CMOS and exit. Yes. And it'll restart. Now, when it's restarting, you want to get ready. Just hit F12. So, rap on F12 as soon as you're powering up. See down at the bottom. And what this gives you is a list. This list is your boot options, where it's going to get that operating system, your Windows, from. And of course, you're going to not want it from your hard disk, which is your information storing device inside your computer, where your operating system normally exists. You want to click down on with your arrows on your keyboard to CD-ROM. And this is where the XP comes in handy. So I'll throw in my Windows XP. Remember, you don't need to do this, so but I do. So I pop in the XP program and make sure that it's set at CD-ROM. Say yes, and get ready because you're gonna have to hit a key. Press any key to boot. You want to hit yes on that, or hit any key on your keyboard. And that's going to bring up your Windows install page, which will look like that. And it'll start loading files. They're handy and whatever, but not really necessary. It's not part of the pro or part of the information I need right now. So I'll let it do that until it gets to the next page. Alright, it's done now. Loading up all the drivers and it's starting Windows. Now for this part, you don't really need to be too worried. You install programs all the time. Basically, that's all you're doing, but you're installing the main program. There, go through your startup. Slow. Okay, you'll get a page like this, which is your startup, and it gives you three options. Set up Windows XP now, press enter. Repair the Windows disk, or which we don't need, or quit setup. Okay, so press enter. And let it go through its thing. This is just an agreement, so hit F8. Now you'll get this, which is important. Partition. Partition 2. Now you notice the different size is 65 megabytes. See, that's where the old operating system used to exist. And how much free memory I have is the second line. Okay, but we don't want them anymore because we're formatting. So you want to delete them. So it says to delete the selected partition, press D. And it's going to bring up this kind of like a warning. You're going to erase all the information, nothing's going to be left. And I'm thinking, yeah, that's what we want to do. So press enter. And then it's like a third warning. Are you sure you're going to do this? You press L. And then you'll see that it's unpartitioned space now. With 101 megabytes and partition 2. We want to get rid of that too. So click your arrow button down to that one and press D again. And then it just jumps to the L this time because it's not the operating system, it's just the memory. So hit L and you'll end up with only one listing. Unpartitioned space with your full amount. Okay, now you want to create a partition there, so press C and it'll automatically detect how much information is storable on that hard drive. So just hit enter, say yep, and you'll see now there's two and it's allotted 7 megabytes for the operating system. So that's okay. Okay, so you want to install. So just hit enter. Setup is formatting. go through that step. It's basically like writing the Windows program to your hard disk and making sure your hard disk boots up properly. So I'll let it go through that. So go to your router, and we'll need to reset that as well, because it has its own built-in firewall, which is kind of handy sometimes. If you have just a basic one, it might not, but I'll show you anyway. You should look for a little reset button. Sometimes it's on the back, sometimes it'll be on the bottom of the thing. So press and hold that reset button for about a minute and a half. Just keep everything disconnected other than the power. Sometimes you'll need to, if it doesn't want to reset, you'll have to unplug it. Unplug the power cable from it, which is that one there. And leave it unplugged for a minute and then plug it back in and try that reset button again. Sometimes clicking it a couple of times will make sure it's act or will activate it. Just watch the stuff on the front. You'll see it flash and go through its reset sequence. So that's a good indication that it actually reset. And then once you're done that, don't plug it into the internet. Just plug your internet cable into one of the ones in the back. You'll see they're usually numbered 1 to 4, and they're called LAN, LAN. So plug it into whichever one you want, doesn't matter. And that's that part. So this is the screen you'll get after you're finished doing the format. It'll switch to this. Oh, on the wrong setting. And see, oh no, this is yeah, 'cause my Windows XP disk was a little bit scratched, so I'm getting an error, but doesn't matter. It's done its format option, which was the main reason I like using it. So I'll just hit F3 and quit, and it'll start rebooting. So get ready to hit F12. So just wrap on F12 because you want the boot option. And it'll bring up your boot list. Pop your XP disk out of there. And grab your Windows 7 disk. Wherever I put it. Fire that in there. Click your arrow down to the CD-ROM again and hit enter. Get ready to tap a button because it'll say boot from CD. And you get a page like this one. Kind of looks like this. With Windows setup, you want it on that. But yeah, make sure it's on that, and then just hit enter. And she'll load up the files. for the Windows 7 program. Let it do that to save time. Okay, you'll get your license agreement again. Like I say, if your mouse isn't working and it's highlighted here, like you can move around on this screen with just your keyboard by hitting tab. You'll see it jumps the cursor up there and then it'll jump it back down there. Just hit your space bar and that'll check it off, and then hit tab again and it'll go to the next button, and then just hit enter. Now it'll give you this page, which is an upgrade. We don't want that option, so just arrow down to the custom advanced, hit enter. Okay, and then we got this stuff again. This is where I get the like double whammy for them friggin' viruses. So we want to kind of go through the same steps. So if you have to, tab to the drive options. I'll just use my mouse, click on that. And then one of them's highlighted, just hit delete. And then okay. And then on the other one, hit on, well, it'll have one only there, but hit new. It'll automatically register how big it is. Click apply. Say okay. And it'll reset it up. It's allotting 100 megabytes for the operating system and 465 left over for memory or storage. So I click on the 467 and click format again. Kind of like a double format. For the Windows 7 program, it does it really fast. Same thing, click on that. Click format again. Just to make sure, or it kind of like double formats it. So click on this one, or no. Yeah, click on that one. The bigger number. And then click next. And let it do its thing. So this is all just automated stuff. It'll go through all the steps on its own. Don't have to worry about anything. Going to skip past installing updates because you're not connected to the internet right yet, which is okay. We'll deal with that later. The installing features is probably, I would imagine, drivers that it actually contains. You see it's trying to search for updates right now, but it's not connected, so it'll just jump past it. And as I just hit restart now, just to make it a little faster. This screen is mine. I can set up multiple hard drives, but not important at the moment. services. Alright, it's probably reset a few times, installed some drivers, your services and stuff. A couple I'd like to show to reset. Now you can put your name in here and whatever, but I like to make it annoying if there's anybody trying to hack your system. Just put in a bunch of spiel. Make them friggin' work for it. And computer name, of course, it'll set it up automatic. You can change that, and that's fine. Oh, it's saying that I'm using something that's not good. Not too sure. And your password, which is handy. Don't forget your password, because you'll have to go through the formatting option again, or could set up a disk. Actually, show you a little trick as well. You can, on your keyboard, instead of needing to remember your password or whatever, you can just make a little picture on your keyboard. So like, if I was to go shift and then Q and then go down at an angle and then back up and then down and then up or something to that effect, make a little design. You don't need to remember your password then, you just have to remember the design that you've created on your keyboard. So I'll do that now. And you can have a pretty intense password and not really have to remember what it is, because you know what kind of design you've put on your keyboard. Password hint. Go away. Whatever. So, it next. Your product key, you can skip this if you want. I would uncheck this, automatically activate Windows when I'm online. I'll show you how to do that manually. But if you have your key, should be on the side of your computer or in your Windows disk case. But I'll just skip it. You can type it in there if you want. So I'll just say skip. Now it's giving you this page. Use recommended settings. Install important updates only. I always click on ask me later. Of course, whatever time zone you're in, find the time zone that matches your area. Okay, where am I? All right. I'm in mountain time. Should set the time automatically. If it's not the right time, you can just
type it in there by just clicking on it, deleting it or whatever, or changing the time manually here, and the right date as well, and let it go through its additional steps. Alright, there you have it, your new desktop. Let's see. Okay, go into your control panel. Find your control panel. And, hold on a second, I got the sink set on a tripod. Right up at the top there, it says category. Change that. I don't know, click large icons. Gives you a better listing. And you want to go into, now remember, if this is Windows 7, what the heck do they call that? Just your basic Windows 7 Home Edition, you won't have this option. But if you get Professional or Ultimate, you will. So go into your Administrative Tools and go down to Local Security Policy. Double click on that one. You get a list of like this. You want local policies. Security options. There you'll bring up a bunch of stuff here. I would recommend you go over to your guest account. Oh wait, this is the wrong area. The one that says rename guest account. Change that to something else. Spiel or whatever the heck. Just type any kind of name in there. And the same thing for, it'll say rename administrator account. Change the name of that to something else. And that'll increase your security. What else? I think that's about it on here. Okay, so on the left, account policies, click on that one. Password policy, nope, that's not it. Lockout policy, that's the one you want. Okay, and then account, oh no, that's not right. Okay, account lockout threshold properties. Click on that one. And, I don't know, put it to 3 or something. This is for if they... so then, if they keep trying to hammer your computer to guess your password, they'll only have 3 chances to guess your password. If not, they'll lock out that account they tried to create. So make sure you remember your password or else you'll get locked out of your own account. So type it, make it at 3. It'll bring up this other window, which is the duration of how long their account will be locked out. You just click OK. But I'll go to account lockout duration. Click on that. Set that to like something crazy, 3,000 minutes, and apply that. And the same thing for your thing, for your reset account lockout counter after proper or after. It's basically how long they're going to be locked out. Say okay. All right, and that is that. That helps you increase your security quite a bit. So you can just close that off. Go into your control panel again, and go to remote app and desktop. Oh, no, that's not it. Just go into your start menu and type it in, remote desktop. And the one that says allow remote access to your computer, it'll bring up another window. Uncheck that, where it says allow remote access to this computer, say new. So uncheck that and apply. And close that off. A couple of handy little things to stop people taking control of your computer. And that's that. Now, your drivers, if you have a disk, which I do for my computer, I don't know if you do for yours, but like I was saying at the start, to write down all that stuff. The one main thing is your to remember what type of network adapter you have. It is optimal to have all this stuff on a disk. Save it all to a disk, either on another computer or something. And then you'll be able to just pop her in and install whatever drivers. But your network adapter is what will connect you to the internet. So if you're running a gigabyte, you'll have probably a gigabyte disk that comes with it. If you don't, you can go to the Gigabyte website, or you can use Windows Update. So install this stuff. All right, setting up your router security. First, you might need to go, if you've reset your router already, by hitting the reset button that's located usually at the back of your router. Sometimes it's on the bottom. It'll be a little button that you'll need a little pokey tool or whatever to hold it down for a minute and a half around there till it resets to the factory defaults. Once you've done that and you have the factory administrator name and password, go to your, or make sure it's not connected to the internet, but your computer's connected to the back of the router in one of them four outputs. Once you've done that, open up your Internet Explorer or whatever you're using, Firefox or whichever, and in your the top, I want you to type in 192.168.1.254. You can get that, and that should hit, connect you to your router. So type in your administrator name, whatever it's set up. Lots of the times it's just set at admin. Type in the password. And go into your router settings. Go to your local network tab or something. And if you don't want your wireless on, just click on find a wireless option and just uncheck it. See, mine's disabled, so I have unchecked it already, and then click OK. Shared storage or whichever. I have mine disabled as well. Services. And you can set up your parental controls even in the Simmons version of a router. But your main issue is setting up your password for your router. So find a change password. You might have just received a password during login, a password change option. But if not, search around for a change password option. And type your old password in. I've already done this, but I'll change mine anyhow. And for this, which is handy, what I like to do is just open a new text document and type in a bunch of spiel in there, just a whole schwack of numbers for your password. You don't have to remember it. That's why you open a text document. And just copy and paste it right into your password. And then click OK. And it'll go back to logged out so that you log in under your new password. What else? There is the option, should have, there should be the option for under either services or, oh no, it'd be under system for the Simmons, but you might have to search around through your tabs and look for management. Maintenance management. just click that one, and make sure nobody else has the ability to mess with your router. So uncheck these, allow other network users to control your router's network features, enable automatic cleanup of old used PMP. So uncheck them, and then click apply or OK, whichever your router shows. And that's about it. Log out of your router, and you're good to hook up to the internet. Before going on the internet, I would recommend you go to Windows Update. Take care of the little setting down on the bottom. There should be some type of announcement. Messages. So just click on the important messages, and off to the left there'll be a little Windows Update icon. Just click on that one, and see what type of updates are there. It might ask you to change the settings or whatever, or decide your settings if you want to change them at any time. The change the settings is there, which I always have set to never check. I recommend anybody that has this do it manually, so check that off to never check for updates, and just click OK, and then your update. You'll have to do it manually every now and then. Just go to your button here. It should, instead of install updates, it should say check for updates or something to that effect. So click the scan, and it'll bring up whatever updates you need. You'll have your Microsoft updates. Recommend you do those. And these are your secondary ones. These secondary ones are important for your drivers. So if your computer, when it did the scan, found any new drivers, it'll be on that option. I've already updated my computer and stuff. So anything that you have plugged into your system should be listed there if Microsoft has the driver for that. So check off whatever you need there. And just go click OK. And then just check install updates. And it'll go through the installation of them. You'll have to restart your computer. And you should have most of your drivers. If your drivers aren't all there, you'll be able to notice by going back to your start menu and typing in Device Manager. Probably don't have to type the whole thing in, should come up, but Device Manager. Click on that. And it'll bring you up with your Device Manager of what's in there. And if any of these are showing an icon, like if it's not a clean list like this, then that means that device hasn't got the right driver there. So If you wrote down all the drivers, like I said at the start, or all these names, just go to the website that contains the driver for that. Don't just click on any driver that comes up on your internet search, but go to, like, let's say I wanted, or if I had a problem with my display adapters, like my video card, that's what that is. So if this was open like this, and it showed an icon by it, and it showed unknown adapters, you'll know what it was. So go to the AMD website and find the proper driver. Search out that driver name I told you to write down exactly how it was written. And once you do that, find the drivers, download them, install them, and you're good to go. Thanks for watching.